Canadian Tire Center on this Saturday night. The Montreal Canadiens and Ottawa Senators wrapping up preseason play as both sides. A few more decisions to be made. And the big storyline right now, Dave, in Ottawa, Josh Norris. You saw him. He skated with his teammates today. DJ Smith frustrated. Josh Norris frustrated. Obviously not medically clear to play yet. And that puts a lot of focus on other players. That means opportunity. And a guy like Ridly Gregg, Ottawa's first round pick, 28th overall, back in 2020.
Well, tied to the injury of Josh Norris is the absence of Shane Pinto. So there's essentially two spots open, the second and third line center spots. They need Ridly Gregg to do what he does. Don't try and do something different. Don't think of this as an addition. He's played in the NHL. Hey, he's played with Claude Giroux in the NHL and scored points with him. So just go and do what you do. Do it at your best, and Ridly Gregg will be just fine tonight.
Gregg tonight centering a line between Sokolov and Schmeichel. Had a chat with Yuri Schmeichel earlier today, and DJ Smith said the big winger from Czechia, one of the guys getting a look, some power play touches. He's a bubble player, as are a few tonight as the puck gets dropped. We're pretty much excited for the regular season. Just one game to go as we're underway here on this Saturday night. Chipped in by Roby Gervinti, who Claire talked about off the opening. Round the boards it goes. Jammed back in by Jacob Larson. Backdoor pass in front as Kubalik tried to center it, and it was picked off nicely by Kirby Dock. Dock to Mike Matheson. Matheson, the center ice for Dock. He'll skate it in for Montreal. Stocks protects the puck. Matheson, left side, floats one in. In and out, rebound, score! Right in front, Juraj Slafkovský. Little momentum for big number 20. Two now in the preseason. It's 1-0 Montreal.
Watching this opening draw, a little smile from Juraj Slafkovský. He's thinking, we have a big game tonight. All starts with Kirby Dock, though, on the rush. Turns it up, finds Matheson, pucks to the net. That's the key to Mike Matheson. And the coaches talked about the number of touches Slafkovský can get during a game. That is one big body, Brian, parked in front of that net. Off to a great start for Slafkovský.
33 seconds in, the first shot on Mads Søgaard slips right by him, and that's a nice sign for Slafkovský and the Habs as Montreal able to control again. Barrett, Loafer, Raphael, Harvey Pinard, top line out for Montreal. Matthias Norlander, little pop pass, Suzuki throws it back into the corner. As Norlander, another one of those guys trying to make a final impression on Martin St. Louis and the coaching staff, a guy who'll get some opportunities on the number one power player, the second unit. Matheson, obviously the guy, but they've been giving Norlander a lot of looks in this camp.
A little bit of a hole on that second power play unit with the injury to Chris Wideman, so we'll look for Norlander.
Monahan floats one in. That one's handled by Søgaard. As Sean Monahan will turn 29 years of age next week, as we'll kick off the regular season in the National Hockey League. Parky Kelly sends it in. Samuel Montembeau, starting goalie for the Montreal Canadiens tonight. Kelly finds the puck, feeds the line. That wrist shot deflected in front. It was Mark Hasselick. Good screen and in front, score! Buried in front, the follow-up by Parker Kelly, and we're tied up at one.
Mark Lathot talked about Parker Kelly before the game as a guy we should be watching. He's got to be part of an energy line with Kastelic. And Taryn Fizer playing in his first National League game ever. Going to get a point here on this Parker Kelly goal. That's where Parker Kelly has to hang out. He's in on the forecheck. He goes right to the high rent district in that blue paint. Pops it in and up over Samuel Montembeau. That's a nice answer by the fourth line.
97 career NHL games for Parker Kelly, all with Ottawa, as the Alberta native has tied things up 1 minute 11 seconds after Juraj Slafkovský opened up the scoring. All right, buckle in here. Could be a high scoring affair. 2 minutes in this final preseason test for both sides. Harbor Jacki tried to work it into it as Max Gannett skates it in, sends it across. Gannett goes to the net. McEwen, the backhand feed, who's looking for Boku Imama.
So there's a passes on score by number 27, Joe Vincent, Parker Kelly. Assistant 38, the Joe
invitation there from Zach McEwen, looking at Arbor Jackeye on that faceoff. And not thinking Arbor Jackeye is going to get involved tonight, but we'll see what happens. Amazing to have the reputation he has, Brian, for someone who's been in the league as short a time as he has.
A tough customer for Montreal, as he is a thick, strong young man in Arbor Jackeye. There's Newhook with speed to burn. Alex Newhook up that right side. They'll skate him with some pace. As the Ottawa Senators, great preseason. We all know, I mean, you want to stay healthy. You want to impress the coaching staff. But, hey, it feels good to win in the preseason. Why not, Dave?
To some teams, it's more important. And when you've had poor starts over the last handful of years, it's very important to play well in the exhibition season. So as much as DJ said, hey, if we were 1-6, I'd still feel the same way. It's good to win. It's good to get in that habit of winning. Garventi, a little bit of a high stick there. Gets it up into Lindstrom's face.
Power play time for Montreal as they'll set things up. Cole Caulfield near circle, on top for Matheson. Mike Matheson at the line. Suzuki accepts, waits towards the net, Ed Monahan. Couldn't quite get the stick on that. Caulfield for Matheson, back to Caulfield. Matheson delays, free shot up by rebound Monahan, in front, through the crease, sprawled out as Sogard. Up to Caulfield, delays, shoots, and again Sogard down and out, and he found a way to stop number 22.
That 6'7" frame was all over that goal line. A mad scramble from Matt Sogard, but he gets it done.
29th Montreal's power play last season, something they want to improve on this year, obviously, is some pretty good weapons when healthy, and Cole Caulfield's a big part of that equation. He'll send it across, up top, Matheson's face, delays, across, Caulfield, one-timer. He saw a little daylight near side, but Mads Sogard, after giving up that first goal on the first shot, couple pick stops here.
You know, Sogard didn't like that first one on the rebound, but look at him work to find the puck, and it is work to find it. That last little pass across, there's the back of the skate coming. It's this one here on Caulfield. Watch the pad up and over. Sogard using every piece of equipment he has, and Montreal finding Caulfield.
Another drive just missing the mark as Cole Caulfield. 3 points in 3 preseason games thus far. It's Suzuki leading the way, by the way. He's got 5 points in 3 exhibition games. Arbor Jackeye back in his own zone. His brother Florian Jackeye, drafted this year by the Montreal Canadiens, a forward in the fourth round. He was part of this training camp early on and sent back to junior. Look out, Sogard lost it in his skates, and then a tough bounce for Montreal, collected by Ottawa to try to break in shorthanded. Led by Ridley Gregg. He'll drop, wrist shot right on, and that was stopped as Nicholas Matin Palo, the Finnish defenseman, got a good look in shorthanded. 10 seconds remaining in the minor penalty as Montreal works it in. Here's Emil Heyman. Takes contact. Tried the backhand. Slashed by Matin Palo. And he's able to clear. It's 2-on-2 the other way. Led by Kubalik. Penalty over. Good stick by Slavkovsky. He got back and broke that up with Jarventi out of the box and looking for an opportunity. Habs bring it up ice the other way. That wrist shot off his stick. Continuing to work is the youngster, Justin Barron. Flip to center ice. Kubalik tried to bring it in deep. He was met there by Norlander all the way to Montembeau. He'll leave it behind his net. Norlander off the ice. Just out of the reach of Jake Evans. Evans on the move. Pass across for Jackeye. He skates into space, picks up the puck, and then shoots it in. Jesse Ullinen, spinning shot, didn't get through. Follow-up, Michael Pezzetta driving his big frame towards the net and couldn't get the opportunity. Held in by Montreal. Little backhand dish in and collected by Jacob Larson. Gannett using the boards, gets it to center ice. As Max Gannett. But all defensemen is scoring in the AHL in Belleville last season. He had 40 points in 72 games. The captain, Nick Suzuki, for Caulfield. Caulfield across. One-time drive stop. Big rebound. And a good rip by Jordan Harris. Got it right on Sogard. Caulfield, the one-handed slash. Keeps it alive in the offensive zone. Suzuki. Caulfield in his skates. Pocket picked. And the other way comes Taren Fizer. As Fizer earned himself a one-way deal in the AHL with Belleville. And as you mentioned, pretty exciting here. First taste of NHL hockey in the preseason.
And a point on the first shift. A nice way to start it.
Caulfield kicks it to his stick. On the puck for Montreal. Cole, Caulfield across. Matheson gets a touch. Lindstrom gets it off the skate of Caulfield. Gives it back to Cole Caulfield. Up for Matheson. Across. Suzuki. Thought about the one-timer. Matheson delays. Brister. And a good block in sight by Imama. Montreal, some good ozone time. Matheson back on it. Delays. Great shot through traffic. Rebound. And Sogard again. Harvey Pinard doing what he's got to do. The screen in front. Suzuki. Harvey Pinard. Spinning around. Suzuki. Flips it back to the point for Matheson. Ottawa needing a change here. Matheson. As they're changing on the fly. And Ottawa tired. As Hetherington into the corner. Lays the body. That'll go down the ice. And Ottawa able to get a much-needed change in and some fresh legs out. Good chance by Kirby Dock. And that is looking short side. Sogard, though, makes some nice stops early. Slavkovsky on the puck. We'll open up the scoring in the opening stages early in the first period. Slavkovsky and Kelly, the goal scorers. Ottawa looking for more. Bots and both. In and out of the glove. As you know, Kubalik loves to pull the trigger, and he nearly snuck one by Montembeau.
Yeah, there's that great look by Ridley Gregg to find Kubalik.
Kirby Dock, the chip and chase. He'll go to work with Yoel Armia. In goes Jarventi into the corner. Dock to the line, able to keep it in. Armia below the goal line. In a puck battle with Jacob Larson. Armia pushes his man to the ice as that battle continues. Well, Armia, pretty good shift for number 40. All the way up to the point. Jacka delivers across ice. Harris tried to feather it in front for Emil Heyman. That was broken up. Nice little pass. Bit of space inside. The forehand big stop as Josh Bailey nearly clicked. He's had a great preseason, Bailey. 5 points in five games. And a great opportunity there from the longtime NHL veteran. It comes Kastelic to the forehand. He really got in clean. And Harris tied him up enough. Didn't get a good opportunity in on Montembeau. Puck available. And this time Montembeau has seen enough. And he'll hold with Kastelic right in front. Has Slavkovsky. And then a minute 11 later, Kelly is 1-1 in Ottawa.
Well-deserved little drink of water for Samuel Montembeau, who came up big coming off a career year. Number of games played in 40 and number of wins. First one on Dominic Kubalik, good glove save. And the second one, Josh Bailey, all alone. Great feed from Jiří Šmejkal. Little move, tries to open up Montembeau, and Montembeau just shuts it right down. It's a big year for Samuel Montembeau, Brian. Coming back as knowing that he's the starting guy. It's his net. He's got to grab it.
16 wins last year, to your point, a 901 save percentage, best numbers of his NHL career. Right off the draw, and Parker Kelly ripped it, looking for his second goal. Zach McEwen, backhand dish, up top. And that drive off a stick and out of play as Nick Mattanpalo signed a one-year deal back in May. We saw him at the World Championship for Finland at the recent Worlds.
So a couple of veteran free agents that Ottawa picked up. We talked about Jiří Šmejkal, who's looked really good in camp so far. He's a big, heavy guy, 230 pounds. DJ Smith talked about him using that word today. Plays a heavy game, seven-year pro, only 26 years old. Got to add those guys to the system. You count on draft picks, you count on trades, you count on free agents. If you can grab a guy or two every couple of years from the European side, that much depth you can create.
Šmejkal won the bronze for Czechia at those Worlds, and he actually played in the Western League in Moose Jaw to start his career. Kasilek's drive didn't get through. And you think a guy from Czechia, we asked him earlier today, you know, his favorite player growing up? Sidney Crosby. He's got a poster growing up in his room of Sid the Kid. So pretty cool, the impact of Crosby internationally. Norlander, cross ice feed. Wanted Pezzetta, couldn't get the shot away. Jake Evans intercepts. Up top, Norlander. He'll zip that across. Ubinen trying to give and go. He wanted to get Barron. Evans long the boards. Up for Norlander. Norlander towards the net. That hit Kasilek never made its way through, and it comes to center ice.
Montreal has possessed the puck very well in the offensive zone. They're looking to make plays. They're moving off the puck. We talked about Caulfield and his last shift, but every line has basically done the same thing, moving the space very well.
Around the boards it goes, right to Yuri Schmeichel. Picked up by Larson. Larson using the boards. Garbenti spun around, but Sokolov finds it. He'll send it down the ice as Sokolov, the leading point getter last year in Belleville in the AHL.
A little peek at the Sens' early season schedule, and what stands out is the number of home games. Just look at that little snapshot right there of the first six, one on the road, and then an impressive five-game homestand. But through this first set, it's so important to get a good start. And look at Ryan Bonus and Steve Scales and watching the game.
GM
Eric Dorian,
yep,
the third member of that group.
The new president of hockey operations, Steve Scales. You got a chance to catch up with him just before the game. And he's hitting the ground running, no doubt, Steve Scales here in Ottawa. Harbor Jacki on the puck, using the board. Suzuki comes to center, and Harris puts it right back in as Sogard out to touch up. Shots 10-8 in favor of Montreal. Pretty good pace to this first period. Good chances at both ends, and both goalies have made some nice stops here in the early stages of this game. As that turnover, kind of a wobbling shot. Tell you what, Parker Kelly, Dave, has been over it, all over it in this first period as he finishes his potty check. And on cue, he's going to cause a bit of a ruckus far boards. He's had a goal, he's had some chances, and he's in the middle of this scrum that continues. Now it's Hamonic in there as well.
Ridley Greig, watch Ridley Greig and Slavkovsky at the top as well. This wouldn't be something Slavkovsky's too familiar with. Ridley Greig would be very familiar with it.
So Parky Kelly's pulled out of the fray. He's going to the box as we'll sort out the penalty damage. Kelly in the box for sure. We'll sort out the rest when we come back to Canadian Tire Center. It's the Habs and Sens here on TSN.
Parker Kelly, the initiator. Travis Hamonic got in to get involved. Did Kirby Dock came in as well, but the hit starts right here on Slavkovsky. And I thought Parker Kelly actually let up quite a bit on it. It was from behind, and Dock gets involved, and everyone comes to join the party. Little show of solidarity early on. Ridley Greig took a couple of shots at the big first overall pick. The veteran Travis Hamonic doing a good job of getting involved there. And when a guy like Hamonic comes in, if you watch what he did, he went to their biggest, toughest guy, and that was Arbor Jacki, to nullify anything happening there. That's a veteran move.
Montreal 0-1 in the power play. Four shots in the first opportunity as they'll hit set up again after winning the draw. Caulfield digs it free. Suzuki all alone, and he let it rip. And I think Sogard caught a piece, stays in play. Suzuki was all alone on an ocean out there in the near circle. Monahan tried to find him again. Monahan up for Matheson. Matheson for Suzuki. Ulinen back to Suzuki. Suzuki, backhand pass. Matheson. Matheson. Ulinen. Back to the captain. Monahan down low. Monahan, Matheson, delays. Tried to get the shot through, and that hit Mark Kasilek, and Ottawa able to clear. Cole Caulfield. 3 points in three preseason games, and by all accounts, the Montreal Canadiens had a great time in Mont-Tremblant. A little bit of golf, signed a lot of autographs, got in some good bonding time And wrapping up the preseason. Look how turnover. Armia nearly cashed as Sogard went for a waltz and lost the puck. Schmeichel able to dig it free. Good job, and he'll send it down the ice. And a guy we talked about, here's Norlander getting an opportunity here on the power play. Here's Newhook. Off the left side, Newhook. Heimonen, as his drive just misses. Emil Heimonen again, battling for position. Newhook on the puck. Newhook, backhand pass near point. Up for Norlander. Newhook. In front, to the forehand, off the post, Armia, follow-up try through the crease. Great hands, but he couldn't click. Joel Armia in front. As that drive off a stick, comes to Armia. Back to 5-on-5, Parker Kelly out of the box. Norlander alertly, though, knew he was coming out of his peripheral and took that away and got it to Newhook. He'll flip it into the corner.
Pretty slick little pass. We haven't seen a lot of Alex Newhook early in this game, but that was a nice pass to Armia tonight.
As he hit the bar behind Sogard, that close to making it a 2-1 contest.
Nick Suzuki, the first chance. Watch the Monahan bullet pass come across here. Teed up by Nick Suzuki from the, that would be from the far back tees right there. And then in tight, Armia pulls it across away from the big goaltender stick and gets it up high, but matches the bar up top. And Joel Armia can show such skill sometimes, frustrating on the offensive side.
Just 7 goals last year for Armia's. Rafael Harvey-Pinard right on, a rebound available, but then Sogard found it and smothers.
Talked about opportunity, and even a game like this, the pace is really good, Muddy. I think that this is the first time I've seen this type of pace in an exhibition game. But I think that is because there are a couple of goals scored early. You know, everybody thinks they can get something going and the energy gets ratcheted up.
Evan Pezzetta, Pezzetta score! Quick strike, Michael Pezzetta. And it's 2-1 Montreal.
Noticeable about how much Montreal has had time of possession in the offensive zone, and Jake Evans, the good scrappy faceoff win, he follows the puck to the wall in the Harris pass, and then just that little slide up to buy space, knowing where that space is in the offensive zone. Watch Michael Pezzetta's route here. As soon as he knows the puck is in good shape, he loads up and he stays outside a little bit higher from the normal coverage area. That high spot between the two D is prime shooting area. He's able to cash it in.
You talk about a preseason game meaning something for some players. Well, for Michael Pezzetta, 7 goals, 15 points last year. He had a career high in goals, points, and games played. Had a chance, Dave, to catch up with him during a charity golf tournament this summer, and he says, I mean, that's the guy I got to be. I got to go every shift and give it all I got to make sure I keep my chair in the National Hockey League. You heard that Marty St. Louis analogy. There's chairs to grab. Grab your chair. And Pezzetta doing a nice job here in this period.
Well, when you're a fourth-line player, the chairs are a little more limited.
Matheson controls on goal, and Sogard able to squeeze. The 2-1 goal coming from Michael Pezzetta as the 25-year-old's made it 2-1. TSN continues tonight with a matchup between CF Montreal and Portland. You can tune in now on TSN. A lot of optimism here in the nation's capital. New ownership, some star players on the rise, including Stützle. Batherson, great preseason. He had a goal, 6 points as well. And DJ Smith talked about it. You know, a lot of his veteran players and his star guys, they're ready to go. He told the media they're ready to go. Tonight's about maybe some of those 2-3 spots that are available. We want to see what some of the guys on the bubble can do. But he's excited about what he's seen from the star players, his veterans. Obviously, the damper, the Josh Norris news. And that was a tough one, obviously, for everyone in the organization, including the fan base.
Well, it certainly was. But, you know, I wanted to play about 4 exhibition games. And that's the number he specifically used. I thought that let me get my timing, didn't put, you know, too much at risk, and I was ready to go. And that's the exact number he said. I didn't want to play Timmy Stoops for more than four. I didn't want to play Brady Kachuk more than four. He used that number. And they certainly performed when they had the opportunity. I think that bonding on that trip probably helped out as well. Out to the East Coast and back to Winnipeg.
Pass right through Monahan, all the way down the ice, and Heinemann, he's got some speed, was trying to get there first, and Sogard probably plays it away. Harbor Jacka at center. Heinemann off his stick as Scarventi starting the play. Good job by Kaslik driving it towards the net, but Samuel Montembeau was ready, and he'll hold. Martin St. Louis, the Montreal Canadiens, coming off a nice road trip and some team building as well. And the Laurentians, and here for the game. Obviously, he skated there, came here for the game. And you know what? He's excited for the season, like, you know, most head coaches are, to be healthy. And here's a look at their schedule to start. Obviously, their rival at Toronto. Have a little Connor Bedard early versus Chicago. Our first game is Minnesota at the Bell Center, October 17th. That's the Habs on TSN. That'll be the first one on our network. And there you see the Kent Hughes, obviously, Jeff Gorton, decisions to make.
It's like Jeff Gorton's a little stressed out for this early in a preseason game, isn't it? The hand on the head.
Decisions to be made as they continue to, you know, the culture in Montreal, developing the right culture, the right players and mindset to continue to get the right pieces and continue this buildup. In the Bell province.
That management team's off to an excellent start. I really feel in the first year and a half that they've been together, they've done a good job of getting the foundation in place, and they've got a nice group of players coming. They know they have work to do, but I think they're going in the right direction.
You know, we got to chat with Kent Hughes at the Under-18 World Hockey Championship there in Switzerland right before the draft, and it was interesting. He talked about the quality of player and who you need in Montreal, not only the talent, but, you know, the quality of person. And, you know, Jan Reinbacher, the defenseman, seems to fit the bill, and he's going to go back and play pro in Switzerland. The young Austrian player, but boy, some nice signs from young Reinbacher, and we got to watch him early.
Well, he and Logan Mailloux, I was very impressed with both first-round right shot defensemen, 6'3", 6'4", long. Marty St. Louis would love to plug them into the lineup in the future, not worry about his right side at all. They both skate so well and use the offense so well.
David Reinbacher, of course, fifth overall. A couple goalies, too, for the Habs. Jacob Fowler, outstanding career in the USHL. Top goalie there. And going to play NCAA hockey now with that powerhouse line from the USA Hockey National Team Development Program that won a gold at the U18s. Led by Will Smith, who was on the radar, of course, of the Montreal Canadiens. Played all the way down to Montembeau. Just under 3 minutes to go here in this first period. 2-1 Montreal as Michael Pezzetta has made it a 2-1 game.
A little more settled now than it was through that middle 6 or 8 minutes. It was end-to-end with scoring chances going both ways, and it's almost as if they've taken a split second to catch their breath here.
Icing charged against Montreal. Okuyama is a great story, Dave. He's a Montreal kid. He went to the Memorial Cup with a lot of familiar sins. Matthew Joseph, Thomas Chabot, Matthew Highmore. He had a 41-goal season that year with St. John. And actually, back in the day, impressed Marc Bergevin when he was the GM so much. He got a rookie trial and trying to make his NHL dreams come true here in Ottawa. He's got one National Hockey League goal with the Coyotes. He played 9 games in the NHL, and the 27-year-old continues to work hard and chase his dream.
Well, he does, and coming to Ottawa, he's got a lot of familiar faces, a little smile, a little conversation with Arbor Jacki that almost cost him, and it's important he doesn't get distracted by a player in the other team, because he was having a conversation with Jacki during the play and almost lost his man going to the net, Michael Pezzetta.
That drive off the stick of Newhook as Gannett pushing play, the Quebec native. Gannett back on it. Nearly put his teammates offside, but it's Newhook on the puck for Montreal with Doc. Newhook cutting in front. Kirby Dock just wide. As those two nearly clicked, Dock took a stick up high. And a penalty is coming up to Ottawa. So delayed penalty with Pfizer on the forecheck. Matheson, nice little move through space. Matheson, he dances in, trying to take it coast to coast. And it's finally possessed by Ottawa. But the Montreal Canadiens on a high sticking call. Back on the power play here late in the first.
We talked about not noticing Alex Newhook early in the game. But the last couple of shifts, he had a great pass to Armi in tight. But watch the speed. It's a little stutter step around. And the speed is what stands out for Newhook. He was represented by Kent Hughes as an agent. So there's the familiarity. The 22-year-old brings a lot of speed. And I think we'll see him up getting a look with Caulfield and Suzuki at some point as well, but I think he's going to be a top six player for Montreal moving forward.
Well, certainly options, right? And there's lots for Martin St. Louis when you look at the combinations. As Newhook was traded for a first and second round pick, then signed that four-year deal. Speed to burn. As Montreal back on the power play. Caulfield throws it to space. Slung right through the crease, but nobody home. It's back to Caulfield for Matheson. Caulfield. Dock. Delays. Assessing some options. It's pinned by Hamonic. Brännström there to help. Monahan around the boards for Suzuki. Suzuki dances in, waits, drops it off. Monahan. Matheson. Final minute. Canadian Tire Center here, first period. As that hit a stick, went wide. And Ottawa able to clear.
Brian, you and I watched Mike Matheson in the morning skates put a bucket of pucks out at the blue line and do exactly that shot that created the first goal with the rebound. But he will shoot that 40, 50 times at the start of every skating session.
Suzuki in the corner. Works it for Dock, or I thought he did, but when you're 6 foot eight and you're Mads Hoggard, you can reach back with that mitt and take it away, and he did.
Dock doesn't have to look up to too many people, but he's got to look up to Mads Hoggard. Wait a second, a big long arm came out of nowhere and the first baseman made the play on the extended throw there. I think he just said something about his height, actually, as he went to the bench.
Well, Hoggard played in the Western League with Medicine Hat, and of course, Kirby Dock with the Saskatoon Blades.
Some familiarity there.
30.5 seconds remaining here. It's been a good first period. Pretty good pace. Norlander, he'll drop it off. Parker Kelly nearly took it away. And this time it is taken away by Hamonic. He's on the move. Hamonic in shorthanded, some space. Hamonic centering feed. And a penalty was drawn as Ridley Gregg was using his pace to try cut in. And you know, Parker Kelly, he's been all over it. He's having conversations, continuing to have them with Slavkovsky. And Parker Kelly noticeable in this first period.
I'm actually going to get Mark Mathot to talk about me before the game and see if I react the same way Parker Kelly does, because he's been very noticeable. And just that chance to give Slavkovsky a little extra shot in the corner. Just watch. Now, the play is blowing dead as soon as it's touched. But Parker Kelly says, wait a second, I got the big guy right here. I'm just going to keep going.
So Emil Heinemann goes to the box, and so we'll close out the late stages here, 4-on-4. Montreal controls. Jordan Harris on the puck.
Good face-off win by Jake Evans against the veteran Josh Bailey with 13 seconds to go in the defensive zone.
We'll have 29 seconds of 4-on-4 hockey to start the second period. As the Montreal Canadiens, it was Slavkovsky opening the scoring 33 seconds in. Then the answer from Parker Kelly, and then Michael Pezzetta making it a 2-1 contest. It is the final tune-up before the regular season begins, the real deal. In the meantime, we'll step aside. Intermission is next. Claire, Mark, right after this.
Good job for Steve Staios. And coming up in the second period, a lot of these players are going to be fighting to have a job in the National Hockey League comes Wednesday. That's coming up.
Jackpot.
33 seconds in, then Parker Kelly, Michael Pezzetta, 2-1 game. And with more on one of the young prospects trying to break through, Claire Hanna.
Yeah, Brian, and Jiří Šmejkal is one of the players that's trying to crack this opening night roster. And even though he's from Czechia, he said his favorite player growing up was Sidney Crosby. He even had a poster of the Pittsburgh Penguin on his bedroom wall. And, you know, he said that there was something interesting he's also noticed about his captain, Brady Tkachuk. It's that he seems older than 24, and even though he's a great person, he says, or a great hockey player, he says he's an even greater person. And here's a little exchange between Tkachuk and Crosby earlier this week.
Just trying to give him a little salute maybe at the end, both teams. Give him a little salute, yeah. Salute, yeah.
Penguins on Monday, but he said it's his dream one day to play against Crosby, and he's fighting for the right to do that tonight, guys.
Claire, that's such a cool story, and in talking to Jiří and having some time with him before the game earlier today, what a well-spoken, thoughtful young man, and we can't really capture it, but the essence of him talking about Crosby and that opportunity. Remember, Crosby had an impact in Prague in 2015. That's when he won his gold medal at the World Championship on that powerhouse Team Canada side. But really cool, a young man from Czechia idolizing Sidney Crosby.
And getting a chance to play against him, and what a player to idolize both on and off the ice, and the pedigree of the championships that Crosby has won in Pittsburgh, what he's done for that franchise. And knows his NHL history too. You know that Jiří Šmejkal is paying attention to what's going on.
And he said he's really been leaning on fellow countryman Kubalík, who's helped him out a lot at this camp. It's his first ever NHL training camp, obviously preseason action. He had a good campaign in the SHL last year in Sweden, their top division, and just a wonderful young man to talk to and get to know, and you can't help but root for a young guy like that.
Interesting with Kubalík and Šmejkal, because Kubalík did something very similar. He came over and played in the OHL for Sudbury, for the Wolves, and then went back. Didn't play, you know, he was a draft pick of LA, but he went back and played in Czechia. So a very similar path. And then, of course, when Kubalík re-entered the NHL, he played with Patrick Kane when Hed got 30 goals his first year. So if that's what Schmeichel's going to do for Ottawa.
Listen, he's a big, DJ Smith said, a big guy, hands. He's got an opportunity on the power play in the preseason. And he's one of those bubble guys with an opportunity to maybe be in the opening night lineup when the Sens open it up for real versus Carolina. Underway here in the second period. It's a power play now as the 4-on-4 expires. And power play opportunity for Ottawa as they bring it in offside. And you look at the numbers last year, a lot of weapons. 8th-ranked power play last year in the National Hockey League for Ottawa, Dan.
Certainly a tier up from where they've been in the past, and you're getting in that upper third of the league with a pretty elite group, and it should be that much better this year with the emergence of Jake Sanderson and Jacob Chychrun on the back end to join Thomas Chabot.
Chychrun, an outstanding preseason as well, and of course, you mentioned a lot of those guys, DJ Smith said, you know, our bigs are ready, they're ready to go, getting the rest in this final preseason game tonight. Here is Kubalík. He'll bring it in with Šmejkal. Jiří Šmejkal setting things up. He'll go up top for Brännström. Šmejkal goes into the front of the net. Gervanti starting the play up for Brännström. Across. One-time drive. Kubalík kicked aside. Good save, Montembeau. And then the follow-up pass by Gervanti. That was intercepted. Good stick and cleared by Montreal.
Excellent read by Mike Masson, the veteran player. He sees the seam just as Gervanti sees the seam, trying to go across, and just steps up and makes that an easy pickoff. So a veteran and a rookie showing both of their experience and lack of it.
Taren Fizer getting an opportunity as we go back to 5-on-5. Good kill. Larson, that was a knuckler hit. I think two bodies and then just wide of Montembeau.
Fizer got a piece of that as well. He's buzzed around pretty good.
Picked up by Larson again. He's on the puck. He'll drop it off. Spinning away is Parker Kelly. Kelly drives towards the net, taken down, back on his skates. Here's Mark Labotte. Talk about Parker Kelly, who he's got to continue to do to stay in the NHL. That's a big hit. That's Heinemann. And very slow to get up is Zach MacEwen. And MacEwen is gingerly going to the Ottawa bench.
Heinemann has had a couple of big hits. He seems to catch people by surprise.
So MacEwen, not the bench. He's going right down the tunnel to the room, so we'll hope that MacEwen is okay. Ottawa possesses the puck. Wrist shot, rebound available in front of Montembeau. Monahan trying to steer out of harm's way, and he will. As Imama tracking him down, and Imama finishing his check on Monahan. Well, Billy Hanneman, 6'2", 200 pounds, and trying to play a heavy game.
They're going to get too many.
That's too many men. You could see that happening in slow motion from up here, Dave.
Zach McEwen, I don't think, expects to get hit here, and you always have to expect to get hit. He's just open a little bit. That looks like an upper body injury there. Dropping the shoulder a little bit as he comes across, and needs a little help going down the tunnel, and he wasn't hesitating. He was headed straight down the tunnel, but Hanneman was traded in the Sam Bennett trade. So Bennett goes from Calgary to Florida. Second rounder to Florida. An awful lot of people over at this Montreal bench. Two guys go on for the one coming off, and just a host of, and that's Marty St. Louis' anger would be at the laziness coming off the ice. That's what he would be frustrated with. Get off the ice.
Cole Caulfield will serve the bench minor for Montreal. 34 minutes gone here in this second period. 2-1 Montreal. As Montreal Canadiens will open up their regular season in Toronto versus the Maple Leafs. Sens 6-1 in the preseason. Claire talked about it off the opening. Their only loss was to the Montreal Canadiens back at the Bell Center. And if you're doing your preseason hockey draft, which I know lots of people do, yes, for Brad, how about 9 points in the preseason?
He was on everybody's radar before the 9 points.
Pretty good preseason for New Jersey in general and for Jesper Bratt. As Yuri Schmeichel, the man we talked about, into the corner, it pops right to Montembeau. So Dom Nicoletta gonna give head coach DJ Smith a little update. Stay healthy, right, Dave? I mean, you've been in many of these camps and preseasons throughout your career. You know, stay healthy, find a way, and that's really unfortunate if McEwen's hurt.
Very often in that last exhibition game, too, and part of the reason for keeping your bigs out is there's just a little bit of a let up in that last game. You can see now, when you start the preseason, it's, you know, it looks like it's going to be a really long run, and all of a sudden there's one game left. You can see the start of the season, and very often in the final game, I believe this pace has been very good tonight, but very often it's not a game that generates a lot of energy, and those are the dangerous ones.
Look out, Max Gannett. He's pressed by Jake Evans. Evans, he got tangled up enough. And Ottawa possessing the puck as Evans able to kill off a little bit more time.
Excellent recovery by Max Gannett. He loses the puck at the blue line, but stays with it and doesn't take a penalty doing it.
Parker Kelly engaging in the corner, able to freeze Sokolov using the boards up top. One-time drive, and that was Fizer. He didn't miss by much. Looking short side. And right on Montembeau, and again, guess who's in front? Parker Kelly off the point shot from Gannett, looking for any sort of rebound.
Fizer getting a little power play time here tonight, Brian. Longtime Victoria Royals. Parker Kelly getting his position in front. Gannett knows he made a good shot, but still rolls the head back.
Fizer now in some distress on the Ottawa bench, so we'll keep you posted on him.
He was down the tunnel as well.
Gannett dishes off. Sokolov shoots right on. Rebound available as Montembeau down and out. It was Parker Kelly in the fray. Kastelic following up. And with 20 seconds remaining, Montembeau, a quality stop.
Ridley Gregg can't believe he didn't put this puck in the net. I think he could see it on the goal line. Watch from this side as the puck comes down into Montembeau's body. Right there, he's got it on his stick. And I think he just shoveled it into the pads and couldn't find the path. This will be a great angle, this. Just a little tight. Oh, ends up on his back. On the back of his leg. And I believe Armia did clamp down on it with his baseball glove approach right there.
back at the preseason game at the Bell Center a couple Wednesdays ago, Ridley Gregg, he had a wide open page in that contest and had that familiar look to the ceiling when you miss. But again, opportunity, young center. And that was that big draft year. Sanderson, Stützle, obviously, still took those three. Sanderson, five. Ridley Gregg, 28th overall, and an opportunity now, as we talked about. With Norris, we don't know about the injury.
And Brian, seven players from that exact draft have played a National Hockey League game, which is just remarkable. I mean, if you hit on a draft, you get two or three players. Ottawa's had seven. If Jarventi were to play, it would be eight.
And a penalty coming up.
So besides Stützle, Sanderson, and Gregg in the first round, Tyler Clevens played. Sokolov's played.
Minor penalty, elbowing.
Marilainen has played. And Cole Reinhart's played a game.
Well, you want to talk about home runs. Sanderson, 8 years, 64.4, and Stützle, eight at 66.8, as Sokolov. See the elbow, so he'll go for two or less, and looking frustrated.
Showing good disbelief. It's a solid look of disbelief for the exhibition season.
But just to put a bow on that story, I mean, that draft class for Ottawa was unbelievable. You got Sanderson, you got Stützle locked up long-term, and massive pieces to your future here in the nation's capital. 8 seconds of four-on-four, and then it'll be Caulfield out of the box, and Montreal, the power play talk right on, and Sogard up to the challenge. He'll make the stop as the shots are now up to 14 apiece here at Canadian Tire Center.
My guess is Nick Suzuki is telling him to hold that for a split second and let somebody get to the net. A little conversation with Suzuki and Doc there, because that's a clean shot, and that Sogard can see it all the way.
Monahan clean win, but too clean. It's all the way back. Matheson collects. Caulfield out of the box, and he's going to stay out there because it's power play time here for Montreal.
Surprise.
Kirby Doc through center ice for Montreal, coasting in, still with it. Doc protects the puck in the corner. He gets knocked down, but Montreal holds. Matheson for Caulfield. Drop pass with a backhand for Doc. Monahan engages. Kasla, good job, finds the puck and slings that 200 feet down the ice.
That's a strong job by Erik Brännström, just buying enough time so Kasla can get back and help him on the clear.
Matheson drops it off. Suzuki over the line. Pocket pick. Good job, Ridley Gregg, and he's on the move. Gregg all alone, a lone Senator jersey, but he'll shoot it in deep and kill off a few more seconds.
Spoke about Ridley Gregg. Besides playing a regular shift, can he do something else to contribute? Penalty killing could very well be a place where he can step in and be a factor.
Suzuki walks it in, drops to Caulfield, and he'll shoot the puck in deep. Doc for Monahan. Matheson, Rister, and Suzuki the tip, and it's high and out of play.
Ridley Gregg has very good instincts on the penalty kill. Just watch him reach in. The focus for Nick Suzuki is on the defender in the middle of the ice, so he almost deceives him. He keeps the stick on the outside, and at the last second flashes into the middle and steals that puck from a pretty nifty playmaker in Nick Suzuki. Smart play by Ridley Gregg.
40 seconds left of the minor penalty. Armia works it down low. Played up top, Arbor Jacki for Slavkovsky, who has a goal in the contest. Two in the preseason now for your eye, Slavkovsky. Armia keeps it moving. Jacki, big bomb, and that was blocked nicely by Parker Kelly. And those aren't easy to step in front of, and Kelly sacrificed and got the job done. Final stages of the power play for Montreal. Slavkovsky leaves for Jacki. Slavkovsky back on the puck. Dances around. Sokolov's out of the box. Montreal still possesses the puck. Wrist shot up high, knocked down and cleared by Larson into the corner. Hademan jumped out of the way and out of the play to ensure there's not another too many men.
He was one of the ones involved in the last one on a lazy change.
To give it going! Again, Sogard got just enough to stop that as Harris was cruising in from the back end. Pazetta finishing his body check far boards as Evans gets back defensively. Into the free comes Roby Gervinti. Trying to get that puck for Ottawa. Dish to center ice. 2-on-2, Montreal. Pezzetta works it in. In comes Evans. Hamonic around the boards, but not out. Gulinen, the backhand for Norlander. There's Pezzetta working for the puck. Evans tried to center. Jam far boards, and it comes to center ice.
We've refound our pace that we had early in the first period, coming off those penalty kills.
Jesse Ullinen fires it in. Sogard will settle it down, and he'll wrap it along the boards to center. Caulfield had Kastelic cruising, but Caulfield, good job to steer it away from him. Norlander tangled up at center ice. Puck at the Ottawa blue line. Kastelic finds it. Pinballs, though, right to Suzuki. Suzuki delays. Rishaw score! The captain, Nick Suzuki, back of the net for his sixth point of the preseason. Montreal by two.
The nifty hands of Nick Suzuki on full display. It's a broken play outside the blue line. Suzuki picks it up. Caulfield does a good job of staying onside right against the boards. He doesn't spring early. A little casual there. Kastelic trying to come across the middle, which you can't do. And that is an excellent shot by Suzuki. Pulls it across so he can use Brännström as a screen. Watch him employ Brännström. He doesn't have it at first, so he delays just a little bit to hide the puck a little bit more from Sogard. Beats Sogard on the stick side. Goal scorer's goal.
Suzuki over 21 minutes per game last year for Montreal. Injuries decimated the team. He had a lot of different line mates almost each and every night, especially when Caulfield went down. Kirby Dock's on the puck. Dock spins, shoots. That didn't get through. Suzuki had a really important job, though, in Tremblant. He had to pick the scramble teams for golf. That's a big responsibility as Dock gets the side of the net. And then Dock gets taken down. Little somersault. Thrown across for Barry. And that eventually finds its way to Matt Sogard. So Suzuki, maybe a future captain for the President's Cup. It's got a goal. It's 3-1, Montreal. That is a frustrated Bokuimama. He is in the box for unsportsmanlike conduct. Brian Mudrick, Dave Poulin with you. Final preseason game for Ottawa and Montreal. And one of our focuses for the Montreal side is certainly Juraj Slafkovský. Goal in the game, two goals in the preseason. What have you seen?
He just looks comfortable out there, and the big smile off the opening faceoff, but it's his ability to find that puck on the Mike Matheson rebound early. He's been involved, Brian. He's been involved physically. He's had a couple of good back checks. He's showing a good stick. I think he does seem a little more comfortable on the right side. Took that big hit from Parker Kelly. He's also been involved in a couple of scrums with Kelly. He was involved in a scrum with Ridley Gregg. Just learning your place. Interesting near the end here. So this is Amama again coming in and taking a shot at Slafkovský. He's trying to draw Jack Eye in. The best way to do it is to go after somebody else and bring Jack Eye into the fray.
Off the draw, Suzuki cutting in, tries to get it in front. Picked off nicely. Here's Brännström. Brännström speeding in. He's got Gregg with him. Brännström cross ice. Kubalik, what a goal! Kubalik up top with a goal scorer's snipe, and Ottawa within one.
Elite skating there, Brännström. 4-on-4, a little bit more open ice up there. He picks it up without hesitation. Watch Ridley Gregg drive the middle. That takes a little bit of space away. Then all Brännström has to worry about is the stick of Justin Barron. So as soon as he can find the lane across, he puts in a good place. Kubalik does what he does. He scored 30 his first year in the league. He can score goals. He's had a good camp.
Dominik Kubalik, 20 goals last year with the Detroit Red Wings. Came over in the deal for Alex DeBrincat as Brännström. Nice little move at center. He's on the move again. Brännström, spinorama, still with it. Did everything but get the shot away. It's funny, you get a goal, you help score that goal, a little jump and a step for 26.
It's just that little, even for a guy who's in a, you know, an NHL player, just that little burst of confidence, isn't it?
Icing charged.
Player like that, it brings him up onto his toes almost when he sees as much open ice. And watch the spinorama here. He shows puck. He's got Norlander on the inside at that point and almost pulls it off.
4-on-4 for a minute 14 here in the second period, approaching the midway point. Pass up ahead for Caulfield. Caulfield puts on the brace. He'll drop it off. In front, Barron creeps all the way in, lost his footing. Couldn't get the shot away, and Ridley Gregg the other way. Good defensive play. Harris was there and ready. Harris will lost it. Gregg back on it. Gregg and Kubalik, the two Senators on the forecheck. Caulfield back to help.
Kubalik was cruising through that slot. Had Gregg been able to steal that back from Harris, he was wide open in front of that net.
Parker Kelly assessing things on the forecheck. Monahan, he'll bring it in. Monahan, kind of a sneaky shot, missed the mark. Larson had him tangled up enough. Monahan back on it. John Monahan feeds the line for Harris. Harris works the cycle across. Nice little move. Matheson, trading space. Backhand across, penalty coming up as Matheson and company drawing a penalty. And finally, Hetherington touches up Montreal Canadiens on the power play here again in the second.
Hetherington gets caught out high, and he has now Mike Matheson in his sights, but a little bit of a mismatch out high and that much open ice for Dylan Hetherington to try and cover.
Hetherington to the box. Habs on the power play. When we come back, it's Ottawa. Welcome back inside the Canadian Tire Center on this Saturday night. Now, usually you're the centerman, so I don't know why I'm in the middle.
I like my left winger on the far side over there, way over.
But
in
there's
another box.
There's a lot better hockey players over there, that's for sure. As you can see, the goaltending coach Zach Burke. There's the captain Brady Tkachuk, and the man a lot of people don't know what we're talking about right now, Josh Norris. But who one feels worse in the building than Josh himself? I mean, he's a competitor. He wants to play. You can only imagine his frustration of wanting to be out there and helping out his teammates.
Even more important to do it right.
Montreal setting up for the power play. Suzuki delays, drag move. What a shot. And Monahan with the screen. And now Jack Eye is out of the box with Imama. So it'll now be the 5-on-4 power play for Montreal for a minute 50.
Very similar to the shot that Nick Suzuki scored on. A little drag and hesitation, so he's changing the location of the puck. That time Brännström's able to get a piece of it, but almost the exact shot, but coming from the opposite side.
Suzuki, Gregg line up. Suzuki able to win it. It's back to Mike Matheson. Caulfield, Matheson. At the hustle, and he's on the puck from Anita Caulfield. In front, Monahan. It was swatted away by Brännström. Brännström in the corner with Hamina. Both sticks swatting, trying to clear. Good dive there. Matheson holds it in. It's great to see a healthy Mike Matheson for the Habs. Monahan, backdoor feed off the pipe. Caulfield tries again. Great setup from 91, and Caulfield couldn't cash in. Suzuki back for Monahan. Monahan. Better defensive play, a good time to Parker Kelly as he reached, sprawled, and able to clear that down the ice. Continuing to put up a nice game, Parker Kelly for DJ Smith. That wrister, Matheson, right into the glove of Matt Sogard.
Cole Caulfield well set up for that shot. He's always ready on this power play, but he moves, so he creates the lane. Almost like a receiver will in football for the quarterback. Watch him slide and create the open lane. He sees where the defender is. One off the post, two off Matt Sogard's shoulder.
Caulfield, 26 goals in 46 games last year before his shoulder surgery derailed his season. Slokowski out there on the man advantage right now. Arbor Jacka getting an opportunity to run the second unit up top. Newhook, good spin move. Alex Newhook, Slokowski shoots right on, and the big frame of Sogard able to block that. Castelic short-handed. driving in on Arbor Jacki. Jacki hits him. 35 seconds left. Kastelic away with a puck. Tried to find Parker Kelly, who is cruising in again, looking for another goal in this game.
Good determined effort by Kastelic to stay with that puck. Very often the power play guys will let up a little bit, particularly when there's two of them there. He out-muscles two of them, gets it out to the front of the net.
Arbor Jacki had this opportunity, Dave, at stages of last season as well, running the second unit from the back end.
Surprised a lot of people, but he shows pretty good skills out there. He doesn't lack for confidence. We know that, and he can really shoot the puck.
Lindstrom, that left side for Ullinen. Penalty expires as Hetherington's back on the ice, 5-on-5, and Montreal yet to click on the power play now, 0-for-5 on the night. Icing charge to Ottawa. Look at Lindstrom, and one of the players, you know, one of those bubble players trying to make a mark, former draft pick of the Red Wings, looking for an opportunity on the backhand. I mean, Montreal, it's another story, Dave. Very deep when it comes to blue liners in Montreal.
They will, and they've picked a couple up in trades, Lindstrom being one of them. He would have been in the Petry trade.
Yep. That shot, Pezzetta in front, Brännström able to clear.
Justin Barron in the Lehkonen trade with Colorado, and these are high pedigree kids, first rounder and the second rounder, respectively, and just building that stockpile up.
Gustav Lindstrom, the goal, 8 points in 36 games last season with the Wings. 128 career NHL games and trying to make an impact here at camp for Montreal's final audition.
One of my players, former players that I coached in college at Notre Dame, Ben Simon, coached him in Grand Rapids and really liked the young man, thought he had a real chance and played 100 plus games for the Red Wings, but they're a team that's got some big pedigree back there with Simon Edmondson and Orit Sider, and he was expendable in the Petry trade.
Won an SHL championship with Lucas Raymond as that comes all the way and still loose against Sogard. Rebound control problems there. Schmeichel trying to disrupt things all the way around the board. Suzuki dishes, Caulfield on the puck. As that one-timer didn't pan out, Justin Barron's got to hustle back. He'll pick it up.
Schmeichel might have got a piece of that stick there as well defensively.
Barron, one of the young guys from Halifax that Newhook knew growing up, played hockey with growing up, him and his brother. It was nice to have those familiar faces. Nice pop pass, 2-on-1. Raphael, Harvey Pinard in. Suzuki, what's hot drive, and he missed. Harvey Pinard feeding the captain, looking for his second of the night.
Well, normally the passer is Nick Suzuki, and that time, roles reverse. Raphael Harvey Pinard comes in and around. The first one gets kind of sloppy in there. Sogard thinks he has the puck in his glove and does it. Watch the pass come across. Nice little sauce on it. And back against the grain for Nick Suzuki, unable to find a net. Suzuki's had a strong effort tonight as well.
Suzuki getting rave reviews from the youngster Philip Meschar earlier in camp about how Suzuki, and much like Brady Tkachuk, how much they care. Young captains, good people, take the time. They want to make everyone feel welcome. Something Yuri Schmeichel talked about with Brady Tkachuk, who we just saw obviously watching his teammates tonight. Special young guys and captains in this league for years to come.
There's a lot of responsibility to wear that letter. Unlike in any other sport, really, nobody defines it like hockey does with it loudly on your jersey. A lot of pride.
Schmeichel dishes in. How old were you when you got to see in Philly, Dave?
My second year in the league, Brian. I was a college player, so I had a little experience, 4 years of college, but my second year in the league, and I followed a guy who'd been a pretty good captain named Bobby Clark, so I always was careful to say I followed him. I didn't replace him.
Good pressure here as Schmeichel had a chance, spinning drive, and that just missed the mark from Jacob Larson. Some pushback from Ottawa as now Slavkovsky on the move for the Habs. He'll drift a shot in, and that time Sogard will find it and hold. Shots 22-18 in favor of Montreal. The Habs enjoying a one-goal lead on the road. All right, Dave Poulin, what was tougher, the root canal you just had a couple days ago or this?
I wasn't very good. I actually look okay right now. I'm doing okay.
Okay, who are we fighting here?
This is Alfie Turcotte, I believe. Alex Turcotte's dad. I'm in the penalty box. I didn't know. This is Bobby Smith. A little bit more to handle here. Yeah, that didn't go as well for me. My teammates would get mad at me when I did that, Brian. They'd say, look, you're not very good at it.
I was going to say, why are you fighting with the teammates you have? It's kind of silly, man.
They would literally tell me it hurts our reputation as a team.
They need you out there shorthanded to score all those goals that you did. Still top 10, if I may, all time. My guy Dave Poulin in the National Hockey League. For shorthanded goals and a Selke winner.
Oh, our producer Sam dug those out of the archives. I would have never seen those clips. It may surprise you, but I didn't go back over my fight archives.
Hetherington setting up behind Matt Sogard. Final stages here of the second period. Just over 3 minutes remaining. 3-2 Montreal leads. Harbour Jack guy. The interception at his own line. Picked off, though, by Ottawa. Trying to track in was Josh Bailey. Off the stick to Arbor Jacki. Off the ice, he delivers. Looking for Hainovic. Sogard out to play it. His backup tonight, Jonas Korpisalo. A lot of excitement for him in Ottawa. Anton Forsberg, a great preseason as well. 3-0 record for him. Habs working around. Big left pad save stretched out. Right in front. Hainovic also denied point blank. Sogard, two great stops for Ottawa.
Matt Sogard coming through late in the period. That pass by Monahan right on the tape of Hainovic.
Look out, Ridley Gregg in on Norlander trying to create some space. Norlander checks him in the corner with help from Pezzetta. Ullinen picks it up. Pezzetta's got to go off. He's lost his helmet, and he will. Ullinen brings it in. Little flip towards Sogard, handled easily. Either got to put the bucket right back on or get off the ice.
Not a bad play by Ullinen, just getting it into the net and then tracking it down himself right there. It's a pretty astute play.
Very Schmick.
Pezzetta was leaving the ice.
One thing that hasn't changed is Pezzetta's salon quality hair.
He works on it. You watch that procedure before every practice and game.
I think there's a great clip out there where he flips it and hits Marty St. Louis on the bench. It's awesome. Here's a turnover. Josh Bailey up the right side. Bailey delays. Looks at options. They'll throw it into the corner. Only three Islanders with over 1,000 games in their career. Potvin, Trottier, and Bailey, as he had 15 years with the Islanders. And now the PTO with Ottawa and some nice goaltending here, Dave.
Some excellent work by Matt Sogard. The first one on the tip, but watch the pass by Monahan coming across to Hainemann. We've noticed can really shoot the puck. We watch him shoot it in practice. I started a story about him. He's been traded four twice. So he was traded four by Calgary in the Bennett deal. And then when Tyler Toffoli went from Montreal to Calgary, again, Montreal wanted Emil Hainemann. He's thought of very highly. A young kid, but man, he shoots the puck. He's also the one who put Zach MacEwen out of this game with a very physical check.
Slavkovsky in on Hetherington. Slavkovsky racing after the puck. Hetherington plays it to the far boards for Gonette. As Gonette's lost his stick, calling for one. Jacki shoots, hit a body, and just went wide. Now, there's two broken sticks out there. Two Senators without sticks right now. Jacki shoots, and Sogard able to squeeze out a much-needed whistle as there's a bit of a yard sale of sticks, and two out of the Senators are going to need some new equipment.
Kubalik, a sharp play from the forward position. He gives up his stick to Max Gwinnett in front of the net so that Gwinnett can defend better. There's the first lost stick. So Bailey's broken his. Gwinnett's lost his. Total yard sale in front, and Sogard does a good job to stop the flow of play and to stop the flow of broken sticks.
Those sticks have probably gone up about 500% in they were a stock since you played.
Oh, yeah.
Expensive shift. Final minute. Canadian Tire Center. 3-2 Montreal.
Hey.
Oh, Thanksgiving weekend can only mean one thing. Tiger Cats Rough Riders on right now on TSN. .2 seconds remaining. Faceoff won by Montreal. Barron. Hayneman accepts the pass. That wrister blocked by Brännström, who had a great rush earlier in the period. He's on the move. Brännström just over the stick of Ridley Gregg. Swung up top. Kamenik for Brännström. He'll load up, hit a stick. Picked up by Mark Hasselnick in the corner, shadowed by Armia. Armia's going to take a penalty. So Armia to the blocks for two or less with 21.3 to go here in the second.
You cannot take that penalty if you're Yoel Armia in the last 30 seconds in your end. You've got to have better body position, better awareness of who you're out there against. And by the way, I did call that line the fourth line, Kasselak, Kelly, and Pfizer. They're the third line tonight. They're normally going to be a fourth line if they do proceed into the regular season, but a veteran player like Armia cannot take that penalty at that point in the period.
Unfortunately for the Ottawa Senators, Zach MacEwen has still not returned. We'll try to get an update with Claire and Mark. And our intermission here at Canadian Tire Center coming up shortly.
Good face-off win for Jake Evans.
Who wants to be more offensive this year, Jake Evans, trying to improve his production. Obviously out here in the penalty kill right now.
Back to two goals last year after having a pretty good year the year before.
That injury and that face-off with Brock Nelson really derailed his season as well. Just the 54 games. So 3-2. And a smile from the captain, and why not? He's got a goal. He made it 3-1. Kubalik Ganster to make it 3-2. The final preseason test for both Montreal and Ottawa. We'll step aside from the nation's capital as Claire Hanna, Mark Mathot have you covered next. Your season, can't wait for that. All right, second period scoring summary. The captain, Nick Suzuki. Assistant, Justin Barron, and then Dominic Kubalik. That was a great goal by him. So it's 3-2 Montreal through 40 minutes of play, and with more on the preseason and this contest, our Claire Hanna.
Yeah, Brian, and it's Thanksgiving weekend, and so you know for sports families, there's going to be chatter around the turkey, maybe about Travis Kelce and Taylor Swift, maybe the Jays' postseason exit. And for Senators fans, it might be, how are they going to get this Shane Pinto deal done? And on overdrive, Brian Hayes and Jamie McClellan, we're asking Steve Staios about how Thanksgiving looks in his family.
We're just wondering if you're going to have a Thanksgiving dinner this weekend and invite family members that will show up and give you their opinions on what you have to do in Ottawa.
Oh yeah. Yes. I heard you guys talking a little bit as I was on hold there, and I didn't know that you knew my family that well.
Yes, exactly. I think every Canadian family is the same.
And Staios says that his family will be evaluating every game this season for the Ottawa Senators.
That's awesome, Claire. Thank you. And I know you have a personal relationship with Steve Staios. What does he bring to Ottawa?
Passion for the game of hockey, just as the new owner Michael Andlauer does. And I worked with Steve for a couple of years in Toronto, and he was just coming out of retirement from playing the game, you know, at a high level. His eagerness to learn, his willingness to listen and to evaluate, and I think he's a bright hockey mind. I think he's an excellent hire by Ottawa, and he'll strengthen that hockey operations staff. And bringing fresh eyes in from the outside is a good thing. He'll be a great addition to this group.
20 minutes remain. Last auditions. Yoel Armia in the box for a minute 39. You saw DJ Smith. 20 minutes remaining to impress him if you're an Ottawa Senator, and for Martin St. Louis. Getting closer and closer to that regular season underway, third period. Montreal on the penalty kill. There is Matheson, and he'll backhand it in. You know, he was so proud, a Montreal guy, returned so many injuries and some tough luck for him last year. Very proud to wear the A this year and have a bigger leadership role for the Montreal Canadiens, something, you know, number eight's very proud of.
Particularly with that young group of D back there. A lot of teaching to do and a lot of partner to play.
Kubalik one-timer off a stick and just wide. Ottawa controls. Brännström will drop it back. Picked up by Roby Gervinti.
Garbenzi, the backhand in. Kubalik trying to club it down at the line in a puck battle, and it's brought in offside.
Coming into a third period like this, Brian, you'll see some of the young players, Zach Ostapchuk, and, you know, players like that, Pfizer, kids who are playing, they know they're playing their last game. They're going back to junior or back to the minors. You look for a little jump from some of those players.
Wrist shot into the glove. Another good chance from Parker Kelly. Had a goal, 4 points in 55 games, 97 career NHL games. Trying to impress the coaching staff, DJ Smith. And just a reminder, just finding out, still no McEwen, still no Pfizer on the bench for Ottawa. So two men short as they round out the exhibition season here in Ottawa.
I mistakenly thought Pfizer was back out for the start of that skate, and he was not.
Rafael Harvey-Pinard was tangled up with Parker Kelly behind the play. Hab shoot it in. Harvey-Pinard on the move in the corner. Quiet by his standards tonight, Rafael Harvey-Pinard thus far in the game.
Just thinking the exact same thing when he got in aggressively on that forecheck. That's much more of what we saw last year when he was at his best.
As Max Binette up the left side, picked up by Greg. Greg waits, cross ice speed, and just over the stick, trying to find Sokolov. He'll hit off for a change with his line mates. Max Binette, 40 points in 72 games last year in the AHL, led all team in scoring in Belleville. He'll float one in. Norlander there, trying to slash it away, cannot. Quick strike, and that was Yuri Schmeichel into the glove of Montembeau.
Really great, coming right across this crease, and Kaslik sneaking in behind Jordan Harris. It's a little bit of a wild pass coming across. A lot of times the passer has to throw it a certain way to get it by that first layer. And it's not ideal when it gets to the second layer.
Norlander, the high flip to space to center ice. Doc on the right side with Slavkovsky. Two big bodies trying to play physical before the goal line. Gustav Lindstrom first on the puck. Schmeichel hits him. Played near wall. Doc on the move again with Slavkovsky. Schmeichel intercepts. He protects at center ice. Montreal in transition quickly. Slavkovsky into the corner. Wraps it along the wall for Newhook. Newhook needs the point, gets it back. Alex Newhook. Lindstrom for Norlander out of his reach. And that's jammed but not out. Held in momentarily by Lindstrom. Good job to get it in deep. Ottawa finally able to clear. Parker Kelly would have been home free, but Lindstrom able to knock that down. Into the glove of Sogard. He'll play it and keep action moving. Kelly right over his stick comes to Arbor Jacki. Okuimama on the forecheck as Jacki plays it across to his D partner and gets it back. Paired up with Jordan Harris tonight. Monahan with some space through center ice. Sean Monahan on it. Centering pass cleaned up nicely. Good defensive play. And it was Sokolov. Puck battle continues. Jacki finds it, floats it in. Into the corner goes Lipsinpalo. Jacki across, wrist shot, and handled. No rebound that time as Sogard able to squeeze.
Zach McEwen has not returned to this game after this. Heinemann hit against the boards. And the roster is complicated right now for Ottawa, and I'm not going to get too detailed here on the salary cap, but if he were not able to play, he could also be a candidate for long-term injury, and that's probably what these guys are talking about right here. And so when the final rosters have to go in, Ottawa would be looking to add a couple of bodies if they were to go in long-term injury, because you want to get right to $83.5 million. So you could use the full amount of whatever you go over long term. So that's a simple explanation of a complicated subject,
but the Zach MacEwen injury, if it were significant, would factor in here as well.
MacEwen, Fizer, both will not return tonight, and you know, why would they? Exhibition game, and no sense to push it. And you hope for the best for both players. Turnover, Jacki, that hit Hamonic. And that allows Josh Bailey to start things up the ice for Kubalik. He'll drop. Ridley Gregg, nice little move. Ridley Gregg in space. Gregg did everything but get the shot away and had it stolen last minute. Suzuki the other way with Caulfield. Suzuki delays. Still in, with it in front. Harvey Pinard found on it. Back up top. Wrist shot. Good glove stop. Jumping into the fray was Lindstrom and swallowed up by Mad Sogard.
Ridley Gregg with a great rush here. I think Hamonic actually distracts him right here. No, he lost the puck. He was trying to move it across. Cole Caulfield stole it. Nifty little set of moves by Ridley Gregg, and then coming back the other way, the eyes of Nick Suzuki find Lindstrom, which finds the big glove of Matt Sogard playing first base tonight for the Ottawa Senators.
Sokolov cutting in. Good puck battle by Ostapchuk. Couldn't get the shot away. Ostapchuk, good job to steal in front. Quick wrist shot, never got through. Hit a body as Gannett threw it towards the goal. Jake Evans, the high flip. Down the ice, Pezzetta picks it up. Michael Pezzetta shoots. And that might have stung Sogard up top. Pezzetta looking short side for his second of the game.
There was definitely room here. We're right in line with that shot. And Sogard had moved his shoulder off the post a little bit. And you're right, Brian. He's shaking his head right now. He got dinged up high on that Pezzetta shot.
Schmeichel, Imama on the forecheck. Chip, but not out. Imama had it, lost it to Doc, gets it back. Doc, then he gets nudged by Imama at center ice. Gastelic on it with Kirby Doc on the forecheck. Worked around by Hudson Powell. Sikorski takes contact as the crowd getting into it on this Saturday night. Habs possessed, wrist shot up high with Doc. Looking for anything off the wrister from Morgan Barron. Justin Barron, my apologies.
Watch Michael Pezzetta come in off this wing and catches Matt Sogard. Look at him, he's just off that post a little bit, and that is a ringing between the ears right now because that hits him right up high. Good up close look at the beauty of these masks. Customized and painted. He's still got a B on top of his. He knows he's going to Belleville. But I think Matt Sogard has a bright future in the Ottawa Senators organization.
21 career NHL games for Sogard. As the 22-year-old continues to make his mark. Cutting in. What a goal! Roby Charvanti out of nowhere takes the puck right through the wickets. We're tied up at three.
How about late impressions? Roby Charvanti, Josh Bailey as well, who could still factor into this lineup. The poise and patience of the veteran. Over to the driving centerman, Charvanti. Head up the whole way. Watch him break through. He's thinking five hole, head up, head up. Finds the five hole on Samuel Montembeau.
Three-three tie, third period. Nice hands, Charvanti, able to finish in tight. As the Ottawa second rounder from 2020, 16 goals in Belleville. They got another. They go back to back. Ridley Gregg and Ottawa leads 4-3.
Seconds after Charvanti ties it up, Ridley Gregg, who's had a strong game tonight. I just spoke about late impressions. A mishandle first by Montembeau and then a second mishandle by Jordan Harris in tight. Gregg stays with it. Find a way. Add a little smile. in a 4-3 lead for the Ottawa Senators.
A buzz back of the building here in Kanata, Ontario.
The great part is it was buzzing at 3-1. Then
another turnover inside. Monahan drops. Hanneman can't catch. Backhand try in front. Going just wide. Chances at both ends. The latest from Yoel Armia, who's had two good looks and tight. He hit the crossbar earlier in the game. Hanneman on the block. It was Parker Kelly got dumped in half territory. Harris backhand in. Shot the boards for Hanneman. He'll barrel in. Round the boards it goes. Raphael Harvey-Pinard leads. There's Matheson. Picks it up. Over to Suzuki. Nick Suzuki. High slot. Drops. Matheson. Delays. In front. In and out of the glove as Sogard flashed at it and he missed. Luckily for him, it was going wide and play into the corner. Kastelic. Away with a puck. Through center ice. Throws into space. In for Branstrom. Branstrom. Backhand beat in front. Kastelic there. Still available. Spinning. Left pass. Montembeau got it up, and Kastelic couldn't cash in. Caulfield the other way. Harvey Pinard quickly for Suzuki. Pick Suzuki. Far circle. Throws it in deep. Caulfield pin, but Raphael Harvey Pinard there. Up for Matheson. He gets jammed up by Sokolov. And Ottawa able to control. Nearly eight gone in this third period, and the Ottawa Senators taking control of this hockey game here in the third. Gustav Lidstrom. In the corner, trying to find Matheson. Kubalik, who has a beautiful goal in this game. Pin Raphael Harvey-Pinard, but the Habs away with it. That pass out of the reach of Jake Evans. No icing. Ullinen on the puck. He'll feed the point. Quick shot. Might have been going wide, but Matt Sogard decides to glove it down and hold for a faceoff. Jarventi, Greg. Two goals, and then Mark Kastelic fishing in the crease, if not for the left pad there of Montembeau. Sean, this Saturday night in Ottawa, Brian Mudrick, Dave Poulin with you, and Montreal Canadiens, you wonder if the preseason actually matters. Remember our Kenzie Lalonde went over the boards with Cole Caulfield? He knew the Habs had not won a preseason game in over 2 years. So does it matter?
It does matter. And particularly when you've had a slow start for the last handful of years, as Ottawa has. Listen, if you've got a lousy record, you tell people that it doesn't matter. If you've got a good record, you want to downplay it. But what does a good record mean? You've been playing well. You've been scoring goals. You want to see people be successful. If all those things are happening, you're winning hockey games. And that's what's happening right now in Ottawa. This is a team where individuals feel very good about themselves. DJ Smith talked about his big guys, how they felt good in their four outings. But think of a Ridley Gregg, think of a Jarventi tonight. Those guys feel good. They're contributing. They're scoring goals. Does winning matter? Yes, it does.
Well, the only loss for Ottawa in the preseason was Cole Caulfield in those halves, and that over the boards was in Montreal a couple Wednesdays ago. And Montreal picking up another win over the Leafs in overtime. And now it's a 4-3 Ottawa lead here. 11:25 to go in this third period. As Ottawa exploding two quick ones here in the third to take the lead. Bouncing puck and whistle down at the line, knocked down by a high stick, so the faceoff to come outside of Ottawa's zone.
Let me give the crowd a little assist here tonight when it was
3-1. Awesome.
When it was 3-1, they got going pretty good. Looking around at a full building and a lot of energy right from the drop of the puck at the start. We had a great start to this hockey game. It was as good a period, the first period. Back and forth and chances and goals. And at 3-1, they were significant. And all of a sudden, it was 3-3.
But Dave, you feel it around the city. You feel it around, you walk into the building, everything from the staff to the players, you feel that this could be a special year for Ottawa. And that buzz is evident when you walk in here. And
particularly, you know, we've gotten to know people over the years, the various people that work here in different areas of the rink, from parking on in, and it's a very, very positive. There's no question about it. They sense what's happening. They know they've got a good hockey team, but they sense what's happening around that hockey team.
And if you just heard, I mean, Michael and Lauer's press conference, and you know him, you have a relationship with him, the way he speaks, how genuine he is, his love, his commitment. How can you not be pretty excited about that passion coming from the owner?
And even when you see him talking to the players, I know players that have played for him at the various levels.
There's a turnover as Schmeichel starting to give and go with Greg. Caulfield getting back defensively. Nicole's done that a couple times tonight, getting back defensively and breaking up some plays in his own zone. Up for Suzuki. Long wrist shot. Why not test the glove? And the test answered by Soger. And you talk about the Canadian cities and the excitement, of course, playing in a Canadian market. Great news. Sounds like the Calgary Flames are going to have a shovel in on a new building in the next few years, so that's outstanding. A lot of talk, obviously, in these parts about a new building at some point as well, and probably adds to some of that excitement as well for the fan base. Zach Ostapchuk up for Sokolov. That was interrupted at center ice. Emil Heiminen trying to dance around Brännström, and Armia was already in, so that is an easy offside goal. What's your expectation for Ottawa this year? A lot of talk about playoffs, wild card. What do you see?
I think they're a playoff team. I do. I think there's going to be some changeover in the Atlantic Division. I could see five Atlantic teams making it. I know there's people that are high in the Metro, but I could see five Atlantic teams making the playoffs this year. I think Ottawa will be a playoff team.
And you wonder, that Vasilevskiy injury and surgery in Tampa, how does that shift the dynamic for that Tampa Bay team that's played a lot of hockey the last few years?
It certainly has now. They've still got a lot of weapons on that team, but I think we know the magnitude of what he did for that organization.
Hamonic right at Montreal's line. Got in that battle with Heinemann and wins the battle. Flipped in. Ottawa needing a change. They'll take one. Montreal controls. Jordan Harris through center ice for Montreal. He fires it in with a wrist shot. Brännström. He fell. Suzuki works it in deep. Pass in front intended for Yoel Armia. And that was broken up and chipped to center ice. Nice steal by Caulfield. Out of space. Cole Caulfield in. And he was tied up and up. Leading for the call. And Caulfield couldn't get that shot away clean. Suzuki trying to get it back to Caulfield. Good job defensively. Ridley Gregg in the corner. He played that well. That battle continues. Caulfield, near wall. Parker Kelly there, as is Harvey Pinard. Caulfield sends it across. That wrist shot hit a body wide. Suzuki, he gets dropped from a knee. Keeps the play alive. One of the Senators has lost a stick. Matheson, a little shimmy, shoots. And settled down by the glove of Sogard. Some frustration from Cole Caulfield, but even he finds a way to smile anyways on this Saturday night in Ottawa. The NFL International Series continues tomorrow as the Jaguars and Bills go head-to-head in London, England. Plus, NFL coverage continues all afternoon and evening long. Don't miss Sunday Night Football between Pierre LeBrun's Cowboys and James Duffy's 49ers. Coverage begins at 9:30 a.m. Eastern, 10:30 Atlantic on TSN. Great Saturday night. Awesome vibe in the building. The youngsters enjoying their Ottawa Senators right now, a 4-3 lead, 8:53 to go here in the third period. I think everyone, including the players, the fan base, excited for the regular season. Drop the puck and let's see what 2023-24 will bring. Slavkovsky in the corner. He gets muscled down by Gannett. Slavkovsky still down, still battling. Puck freed up, controlled by Ottawa, but Matheson swatted it down and still controls. Good job by Matheson. And he gets he spun around. Parker Kelly's space. Ridley Gregg throws it back. And that drive just tied up as Schmeichel couldn't get a clean release. And Montembeau did the rest.
There are no more penalties in this game because there could have been three right there. couple of veteran refs, Eric Furlan, Garrett Rank, say, play it out, boys. Last game of the exhibition season. Lay it out.
8 minutes of preseason remain. Norlander some space. Norlander, wrist dirty, missed. Wide with a shot. Larson tried that stretch pass to open ice. Intercepted by Barron for Pezzetta. Norlander in, shoots in and out. Good stop. Rebound was available, but again, Sogard got enough. Josh Bailey hammers it in. Kubalik, Farborns works it down low. Just over Jarventi's stick. Battle continues at the halves line, and Ulinen frees the puck. Both teams changing. Norlander, part of that conversation that the Montreal Brass will have to decide that opening night roster. Here's Monahan. Tried to lay it across. Armia picks it up. Looks like he kept it in, and yes, he did momentarily. Now it's jammed out. Back to Armia. Arbor Jack guy. Backhand dish. Took the late shot and stood up. Mentzenpalo. Igor Sokolov. In tight quarters. Joel Armia. Find his own net. Sokolov hits him. Gasolik. Able to pick it up. Sokolov behind the goal line. Lays it all the way up top. Brandstra, stick handling, still with it. Little head fake, doesn't pull the trigger. Sokolov can't get a clean shot. Harris able to break that up, and he tries to skate it off ice, and he will. Jordan Harris, it'll flip up that right side. Harris goes into work. Chases after it, round the boards. Picked up by Caulfield. Caulfield, little spin move. Drops it off Hermia, up top Norlander. They'll work it across. Little puck bobble, back up to Norlander. Norlander fires, tip, score! The tip in front, some sweet hands. And the Montreal Canadiens have come all the way back. They've tied it up 4-4. And who's
Monahan, I believe,
the veteran hands, the tip in front from number 91, as the Habs not going quietly, dude, Dave.
He's had a good game tonight. He's had a couple of excellent passes, and Norlander just gets it through, and just a touch by Sean Monahan affecting the screen in front of the net as well as the stick position. Montreal with a good fish. Norlander actually had three or four chances himself there, but Montreal finds a way to get one. 6 minutes and 3 seconds left in this hockey game. They're not going away, you're right.
And Dave, a healthy Sean Monahan is a dangerous weapon for Martin St. Louis and this team.
I think the most surprising thing when he was traded was that he was only 28 years old. And it seems like he's been around forever, and the 182-point monster season in Calgary was such a professional, good on faceoffs, good teammate, good all the way around. There was speculation he would be moved to the trade deadline, and I thought, I think Montreal wants to keep him, and they did.
Says he feels as good as he's ever felt. We talked to him earlier in training camp. Was actually nervous, Dave, admitted, nervous. NHL veteran for a preseason game because he hadn't played in a long time. He wanted to get touches. He wanted to get back on the ice. He's had a wonderful exhibition season for Montreal, and that little tip has made it a 4-4 game.
As you might imagine, when you have the hip injuries that you had, the compensating you do with the rest of your body to try and alleviate the pain. He's skating pain-free for the first time in a long time, and it shows.
Veteran leadership, obviously very solid in the face-off dot as well for this team. Just brings a lot of things. He'll turn 29 years of age, and you're right. I mean, broke in Calgary as an 18-year-old. Injuries, obviously a big part of the story for Sean Monahan, but he was thrilled. He wanted to be back in Montreal. He wanted this opportunity, and he's going to be a great guy and a voice in that room for leadership.
The Ottawa area, very familiar with him from his junior days as an Ottawa 67, where he starred before the Calgary Flames took him west. And Jeff Gorton and Kent Hughes. Jeff Gorton's a lot of expression.
He's just warming up for the regular season. He's getting ready for the real deal.
Every time we check him out, he's got something going.
Gannett trying to give and go as Nelson sends it across, and Kasselik was poke checked. Lost the puck. Kirby Dock speed up the right side, cutting in. Talk, grab try. And couldn't use that long reach and tuck it by Sogard.
Okay, well, the reach is long on Kirby Doc, but it doesn't match the leg on Matt Sogard.
You are correct.
Long and longer. 6'7" brings a lot of leg with it.
Dylan Hetherington behind his netminder. Pass out of the reach of Sokolov, and that should and will be icing charge to Ottawa.
Over all of your both sides of the management team, you're quite pleased, I guess. I don't know how happy you get with exhibition games, but you're pleased with the effort tonight on both sides. You see Jeff Gorton and Kent Hughes and the two-man team, Pierre Dorion on the right, CeCe Stalos in the middle, Ryan Bonus on our left.
Hetherington, backhand dish. 4 minutes remaining. 4-4 tie. 36 shots for the Montreal Canadiens, 25 for Ottawa. Caulfield, nice little touch sauce back to Suzuki. He'll weave in. Over to Harris. Harris works it in for Harvey Pinard. Harvey Pinard below the goal line. Takes contact. Suzuki, his turn to work. Harvey Pinard in front. Quick shot, score! Goal! Caulfield, 5-4, Montreal!
He's been around that puck all night. The number of touches he's had in this game, just remarkable for Cole Caulfield. And gets a slick little pass. Ridley Gregg loses control of the puck, and Nick Suzuki just manages to get it out to Harvey Pinard. I think this goes off Travis Hamonic in front of the net and up and over the shoulder of Matt Sogard, who's battled hard tonight. Cole Caulfield, a little smile because he knows he got away with one there. Not the cleanest of shots and not his best chance tonight by any means, but Ridley Gregg, who scored the goal to go ahead, 4-3, now gives one back to Montreal. What a little turnover in the end.
I'm going to set the line for you. 38.5, Cole Caulfield, over or under for goals this season. 38.5 is my line.
I think he's going north of that.
Yeah.
I think a healthy Cole Caulfield, a healthy Nick Suzuki, and whoever ends up winning, and I do say winning that position on the right wing, is going to be an electric line in the National Hockey League.
Well, I mean, his on pace last year, he was at one point scaring that 48, 49, 50 mark, and then unfortunately that injury. But Cole Caulfield, my goodness, outstanding numbers, especially under Martin St. Louis.
He has always found open ice. We go back to following him as an under-18 player in the World Championships and watching him come up through, and the question, can someone of that size thrive at the highest level of hockey? And we both thought he would, Brian. We were confident that, you know, that when he fell to Montreal with that draft pick, and I believe it was 15th that he went.
15th, right after Cam York to the Flyers, his teammate at the United States national team.
And the people that knew him well were in disbelief that he lasted that long, and Montreal was thrilled to be able to land him. And he's just beginning to reward Montreal and their fans with his play.
Had a 72-goal season, tied Ovechkin's tournament record of the U18s for goals in a tournament with 14, and has continued scoring ever since. Nice little move and some good pace by Gregg. Swinging drive. And Sogard thought about going to the bench with 2:09 to go, but he'll retreat, trying to get that extra attacker out. It's Monahan's on the puck. Monahan, Jack Eye, wrister off the pipe. Harper Jack Eye nearly brought the insurance down at Canadian Tire Center as that wrister off the stick and wide. He was walking right in and was that close to sealing things for the preseason.
Sean Monahan, who scored to make it 4-4 with a tip in front of the net, finds the puck on his stick. Harper Jack Eye thinks it went in the net. Let's check this out. Ooh, that might have
Well, the twine was tickled.
That might have gone in the net. that went
wow,
in the net.
Right
that
through the net. Net.
That's a goal.
That is a goal. That is a 6-4 advantage.
That is a goal. You can see the puck burn. Look at closely. You can see the puck burn. That's what Eric Furlatt is looking at right now. He's pointing it out right now to Jonathan Deschamps. You can see the black rubber puck burn on the mesh.
Well, at least Jack Eye's shots in midseason form with a velocity. That was a rocket.
They're giggling about it there now. Definitely in the net. The shooter knows it.
After further review, the puck went through the net. Therefore, it is a good goal.
They feel good in preseason too, don't they, Dave?
This would classify under things I never did. I never shot a puck through a net. The velocity of that one. Boom.
Marty knew.
Yeah, Marty wants it up on the scoreboard. He wants it verified.
Like it's verified. It's verified on TSN. It's verified now officially in the building. Arbor, you got it. Yeah, there you go. Two minutes remaining in the preseason for Montreal and Ottawa. A 6-4 advantage. 10 goals on the board tonight.
Montreal goal.
Entertaining game, Dave. I mean, both ends. It's been a lot of fun to call.
Positive play of individuals, Brian, is what satisfies management. They've gotten some very good efforts out of some individuals that they have to make decisions about. And if you do have to make a decision and send a player to the minors or back to junior, you'd rather do it on the strength of a good game.
We'll stop Chuck up the right side for Ottawa. Norlander and Slavkovsky go to work for Montreal in the corner. Puck swung up high slot. That wrister off the stick of Doc as the stop truck was looking for a late strike. Final minute, Canadian Tire Center. Next stop, regular season, as the Ottawa Senators will travel to Carolina and Montreal off to Toronto. Evans tried to slide that up top. Feeling. Try to work that up ahead for Schmeichel. Harris behind his goaltender. Evans delays. 25 seconds left. Dumped in by Montreal. That hits the stick and out of play.
Day off likely for these teams tomorrow and then back to work with practice on Monday with close to final rosters, although in both cases, principally in Ottawa's case, as they sort through the Josh Norris situation, they'll have to be decisions made on exact rosters.
And Dave, too, I guess a chance to finally practice, like practice with your team,
exactly.
Special teams, whether it's, you know, 5-on-4, 5-on-3 situations, penalty kill, a chance to get some good practice in and really get ready for game one.
There was a year playing with Mark Howe, and I didn't see him until the 3 days before the season started. Not once. He was in a different exhibition games all the way along, and we introduced ourselves and went out and played the season.
Exhibition over, Dave. Regular season around the corner. The Montreal Canadiens and the Ottawa Senators, both of their preseason losses, for whatever that's worth. 6-4 the final on this Saturday night. And we are ready for the regular season, Dave Poulin. What are you looking forward to?
Excellent hockey, and I think the upswing of these teams, these two teams specifically, but all across the board, I'm looking for very exciting hockey from the groups that we get to see on a nightly basis in Winnipeg and Ottawa and Toronto and Montreal, and looking forward to another year at TSN and some great hockey, Brian.
Cole Caulfield, big smile, talking to his captain, Nick Suzuki. Preseason done. Regular season around the corner. Just a reminder, Flyers, Senators. That's the debut of Canadian Tire Senators Hockey. Gordon and Jamie have you covered. 12:30 Eastern, the pregame show. On behalf of myself, Dave Poulin, Claire, Mark, thanks for watching. Good night from Ottawa. SportsCenter next. Tessa, Nikki.